Now, while we have installed the app, we aren't really doing anything useful with it yet. Let's add a slash command first. Give it the name setAlarm, followed by a description. In at time, followed by a description. This syntax hint will be shown to the user along with the description of the slash command. Action that we should select for the slash command is send to event listener URL. So, as I mentioned earlier, slash commands are also sent as events to your app. And this is what we are choosing to send. There are a couple of other actions like opening a widget or opening a browser in response when a slash command is triggered, but for now, in this case, we will send an event to our event listener URL. So let's save this and reinstall the app. Now let's see if this slash command is available in our app. Yes, it is. Set alarm in 2 hours. But when we enter the slash command, nothing happens, which is obvious since we've not written any code to handle that. Since we're sending a slash command to event listener URL, we can handle a slash command just like we handled app installs, which is use flock.events.on. The event for slash command is clients.slash command. This is the event that is sent along with the slash command, and these are the event attributes that we get. We are mostly interested in the text attribute, which will contain all the text that follow the slash command. So when I type something like set alarm in 2 hours, do something, the text will be this string, in 2 hours, do something. So let's handle the slash command. To parse the time string, I am going to use this library called Chrono. What I'll do now is that I will paste some code that I had written earlier to handle the slash command. We parse the date out of the command text and create an alarm which comprises of the user ID and the time and the remaining text. This alarm is added to the store, and also a timer is set to trigger the alarm at the appropriate time. Let's try this out now. Now, if we detect the time out of the command text, then we say that alarm was added, otherwise we return text which says alarm time was not specified. Let's see this in action. See, we get alarm added. If we send some gibberish instead of time, we get this, alarm time not specified. So for any slash command, you can return a JSON object with a text value in it, and whatever text you provide is displayed to the user.